Shalom, shalom, it's the brother Kadash. I'm going to start off by giving all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekha Kadash. Just sitting here on a Sabbath day, just getting into the spirit to make a lesson. And the title that I came up with is Yahweh Shai, you know, was betrayed by those that he loved the most. Or, you know, something on those lines of he was betrayed by those that he loved the most, you know, because it's the times that we're getting to those times, you know, where you're starting to see things get harder for people, right? And they say most likely, you know, if something happens to you, the first place they look for clues and suspects is the people that's closest to you, you know, so you have to watch out for that, you know. And just like with Yahweh Shai, you know, of course, with the 12, there was a traitor, you know, and you have that amongst all these different groups and amongst us, the body, you know, Israel. You have traitors, you know, the guy that's standing right next to you could be that, you know. So that's why a lot of elders give out the advice that, like, if you ain't known a man for 20 years, then you really don't know him. Something on those lines, right? So we're getting into these times where I feel like these things are going to start to manifest themselves, and you're going to start to see more of this come into play, the whole trading thing, you know, when all hell breaks loose. See, the thing is like right now, how we're living right now, we have luxuries, you know, we have the internet, you know, for the most part, brothers that's even the truth aren't like just super like third world country poor. Even if they are poor, we're all in captivity, we get that, but they have means to get food, clothes, shelter, so things are kind of a little bit relaxed right now. You know, the test is going to come in when you're going to see those things change, when things get harder, and you're starting to see that. Like, I mean, shit, I did made a couple videos, there's been power grid issues where people haven't been restricted to how to use their electricity or their air conditionings. You know, there's been droughts, there's lakes and shit that's drying up, you know, and everybody, you see all these prepper channels, you see all these different channels, all they're talking about is, look, man, this is about to happen. And pretty much it's all doom and gloom. Like, this is what they're saying is about to happen. And then war is a part of that too. This war, if this goes off, people are going to be there's going to be famines, you know. Pretty much the U.S. is fed by China, you know. If certain things happen and China has to, you know, pretty much stop exporting, and they have to just worry about feeding their own citizens, how does that look for Americans? You know, there's been a lot of things going on about, you know, having to make different decisions on who starves or not, you know. And we know 9 times out of 10, you know, whenever that happens, the undesirables, who's going to be chosen to be left out, is going to be our people, you know. And then what happens to our people? Well, it's just like, what's that saying, crabs in a bucket, you know. We start trading on each other, we start setting each other up just to get by, and you're going to have that, you know, especially when the temptation comes of the mark of the beast. And you're going to see, man, I'm telling you, man, because I didn't have visions about this, I'm telling you, it's not what you think it's going to be, man. It's going to be way worse and way vicious than what you see, man. You're going to see some of your top people that you look up to get dealt with. You're going to see brothers trading on brothers. You're going to see brothers getting caught up in some fucked up shit. And I'm talking about brothers that's in the truth that go out there with garments and fringes on. You're going to see those things. And you're going to see some spiritual power coming from brothers. You're going to see some brothers being saved, you know, the mystery of our the strangeness of our salvation. You're going to see those things, you know. You're going to see it all over the spectrum, right? So you're going to have to watch out for certain things, man. But what's edifying is to know, like, that even Yahweh Shai, you know, those that loved him the most, you know, and that, and who loves you the most today, your families, man. You're going to see families split up. We've seen this when the pandemic first hit. We've seen how families were split up. We've seen how, I heard the stories of brothers putting up videos about their wives going to go take the jump shot, and they ain't want to take it, you know, and it caused disruption, and it caused a lot of disruption in the family. You're going to see that, and Yahweh Shai warned us about this, right? Because this is what he had to go through, pretty much, you know. Because he said, who's my brother and my mother? Those that do the will of my father. So the 12 was his brothers, and he got traded, but not just by Judas, but by the people, you know. Those wicked Pharisees and shit were able to, the chief priests and stuff, like, they were able to persuade the people also to go against him. right? And what's going to be the first thing that happens when all hell breaks loose? And it's hard out here for our people. The ones that don't want to follow the Lord, who they going to point the finger at? They're going to point the finger at us, man. Who they're going to come after? They're going to come after us. We in a small city where we teach. And, you know, as far as any other Hebrew, Israelite, one Western camps, we don't see any in our city, you know. We searching, we looked around, we don't see any. So really, it's just me and Quana that be out there. So when all hell break loose, right, who you think they going to be pointing the finger at, man? Now, imagine that being in a city with no water, no lights, and everybody's after two dudes that's in the city. You know, y'all was just labeled terrorists, and then you're on the run in your city, and it's just y'all two, right? And then your family members start to trade on you, and Esau puts the squeeze on it, and y'all running, hiding, trying to survive. How you gonna survive without the Lord being there for you? It's pretty much impossible, you know, especially in small places like where we're at, but even in the large places, in the big cities, man. So you got to understand that, and you just have to get ready for it, and you have to understand that you're gonna lose a lot. It talks about those that should lose their life should find life. Those that should try to find life should lose life. That's in Matthew chapter 10. You're gonna lose a lot. You know, the things that you have to look at these things. It's just temporary things that you use. You use, but you don't abuse, right? And when the time comes, you're gonna have to be willing to give up everything, man, just to scarcely make it, right? So let's go into the Bible. This is Matthew 27. Everybody should know this is a very important chapter, right? I want to start at verse, just kind of go over a story, you know. 15 says, now at the feast, the governor was wont to release unto the people a prisoner who they would. So you guys all know this story. It says, and they had then a notable prisoner called Barabbas. Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, who will ye that I release unto you? Barabbas, or Yahushua, which is called Amashiach, which he didn't do anything wrong, but he's being held a prisoner. So those laws and shit, that shit's bullshit, man. We all know that Esau could come and do whatever he wants to do whenever he wants to do it. It says, for he knew that the envy they had delivered him. And this is still to this day, still could be done that way. It says, when he had sat down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him saying, have thou nothing to do with this just man, because he was innocent. It says, for I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him. It says, but the chief priest, now check this out, but the chief priest and the elders, so the elders, the chief priests persuaded the multitude that they shall ask Barabbas to destroy Yahushua. So these chief priests and these elders, just like today, like you would say that they were men in the truth. You would say that that's who people looked up to as being the man in the truth and the man of the Lord during that time. And that's real, you know, but they had a big part in persuading the multitude, right? Let's keep going. It says, the governors answered and said unto them, whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you? They said, Barabbas. So it's like today, you got to be careful. Like, we all look up to people that we learn from, but at the end of the day, you got to give all praises to Yahweh and Yahweh Shai, because you just never know, man. These people, look, the elders and the chief priests, people looked up to them, but they were the main ones persuading for Yahweh Shai to get destroyed. You see? So really, it's hard to have a order, like a heavenly order set up. You can set up different things when brothers come together. Of course we do that. But like, to be a closed off group like that, it's kind of hard to do that, because you just don't know. You don't know who the elect is. You don't know who's the traitors. You don't know who's the agents. You don't know who's in the wrong. You may feel 100% that you're in the right. You think this whole multitude, everybody in this multitude was just completely wicked and knew they was just going against him. No, they were persuaded. They felt that they was actually doing the right thing, but the whole time they was doing the wrong thing. And you have to be very careful that you don't end up in that situation of thinking you're doing the right thing and you're going the right way, but in reality you're going the wrong way. That's why you have to have fear in the Lord with everything you do. The fear in the Lord is very important. So like, if you get in a situation, you handle that situation to the best of your abilities based off the Bible, the law, statutes, and commandments. You don't, you know, handle it one way with people you like, handle it another way with people that you don't really care for, because really you're taking the fear of the Lord away. You know, you could be judged for that. You know, like I said, you could feel like you're doing the 100% right thing, but really you're in the wrong. It says, verse 21, but the governor answered and said unto them, whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you? They said, Barabbas. Pilate said unto them, what shall I do then with Yehoshua, which is called Mashiach? They all say unto him, let him be crucified. It says, and the governor said, why? What evil has he done? But they cried out more, saying, let him be crucified. That's what's going to happen to us today, man. Us brothers in the truth. When that hell comes on our people Israel and they done and they just tired of it, they gonna say, look, man, those guys, Esau could do false flag attacks. There ain't no telling what Esau could do, man. But he could point the finger at us in some type of way. And then our people's gonna point the finger at us too, say, look, man, those guys right there, they're wicked. They're evil. I seen it on the internet going through a comment board. I just put up a video about a guy that was claiming that America was sold to settlers from from the Indians. That's how they got America today. And you can see that people was on there, man. And you see a lot of comments. It was on a Vocab Malone. It was on a Vocab Malone fucking video. Salaki, it's on Vocab Malone video, and you could see a lot of people on there. They was calling us evil. But what did it say? That's in let me see if I can get that. They was calling us evil. And it's like, what? It's like, how can y'all call us evil when we're the righteous ones, man? How can you guys call us the evil ones? We're the ones that's pushing to follow the Lord to the best of our abilities. Now, does that make us perfect at doing that? No. Does that mean that we don't do no wickedness? No, because we all have some wickedness. But we're trying our best to our best of our abilities. Judges chapter 5, we're rehearsing the righteous act, right? This is Isaiah 5, verse 20. It says, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter, right? So that's what they do. It says, woe unto them that are wise in their own eyes and prudent in their own sight, right? So we're not wise in our own eyes or prudent in our own sight because of this, because we follow this right here. And this is the difference, right? So everybody has wickedness, but this is the difference, right? Between those that's just completely wicked, the two-thirds and the one-third, right? That's not perfect, but is trying to their best of their abilities. This is Romans chapter 3, verse 1. What advantage then has the Jew, or what profit is there of circumcision? Much every way, chiefly because unto them were committed the oracles of God. See? For what if some did not believe? Should their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? God forbid. Now watch this. Yeah, let God be true and every man a liar, as it is written, that thou mightest be justified in thy sayings, as it is written, though, and mightest overcome when thou art judged. So we get in this Bible as it is written and try to live by the law, statutes, commandments that we follow in this Bible as it is written. That's the difference, right? Here, let me jump back to Matthew's, right? But they gonna point the finger at us and call us evil, man. And they gonna come up against us, man. And it speaks about that in Matthew 24. Hold on, let me finish this off. Matthew 27, verse 24. When Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather, because it was a great multitude, right? Rather atonement was made, he took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See ye to it. So he even saying, look, he's innocent. And he said, look, I'm innocent of his blood, but he not though, right? But these, and who's the people that's guilty of it? The people that Yahushua loved the most, his own people, Israel. It says, then answer all the people and said, his blood be on us and our children. Who's that? The Israelites, even to us to this day. The blood is on us, and we would be those children, you know, of our ancestors, even to this day. So it was his own people, right, that did him the worst. Not even an enemy, so we really ain't got to focus too much on Esau. Really, it's going to come by the way of your own people, the people that's closest to you. This is what's going to come. Matthew 24, starting at verse, straight to the point. Verse 8, all these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted. Who's going to deliver you up to be afflicted? Is it going to be the other nations? Yeah, it could be. But for the most part, it's going to be your own people. Just like they deliver up Yahusha to be afflicted. It says, and should kill you, and ye should be hated of all nations for my name's sake. Just for pushing this truth, man. They're going to come up against us. they gonna call you terrorists. It says, and then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another, and many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. Why? Because they're not coming off Romans chapter 3, as it is written. Right? It says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold, but he that shall endure until the end, the same shall be saved. And that's why I'm doing this lesson, to give you the faith, to give you an understanding, the wisdom, the knowledge, to see what's about to happen and see what's coming, so you can endure to the end, man. So you can be saved, because those that endure to the end, the same should be saved. So let's give you another example. This is in Luke chapter 12. Let's give you another warning, as it is written. As it is written, remember, this is Luke chapter 12, verse 51. Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth, I tell you nay, but rather division, right? From henceforth there should be five in one house divided, three against two, two against three. Who's that? The people that's closer to you, your own people. The father should be divided against the son against the father, the mother against the daughter against the mother-in-law against the daughter-in-law, and the daughter-in-law against the mother-in-law. We've seen this when the pandemic happened. We've seen this happening on a lower scale. So imagine when the MOTB is out. It says, and when he said also to the people, when ye see a cloud rise off the west, straightway ye say, there come a shower, and so it is, right? And when ye see the south wind blow, ye say, there will be heat, and it come to pass. Ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky and of the earth, but how is it that ye do not discern this time? And that's why I'm making this video, because I'm discerning the time and what's about to happen and warning the people, look, this is about to happen. Just like all those prepping channels I talk about, what are they doing? They're discerning the time and they're telling you, look, there's going to be war. Russia, America is going to be involved. Nuclear missiles is going to be involved. They're saying, look, there's famines coming. There's droughts. They're saying that the power grid is going to come down. They're discerning the times and they're telling the people that it's going to come. It may not come exactly when you say, but eventually it's going to come to pass. So what we're trying to do is warn the people that would hear, the elect. We're trying to warn them that would hear this, that look, man, not only do you got to watch the other nations, you got to watch the people closest to you. You know, what's that saying? Tighten up your circle before they hurt you. And that's very real, you know. So hopefully this has been edifying. I'm not going to make it too long. With that, I'm going to say salvation to the elect. Shalom.